Hello, I'm Todd Magnuson, one of the original cast members here on the Captain Caribou Show. Back in February of 2001, me and Santa Rat and this other guy, well, we started the show. But since then, cast members have come and gone. For example, this guy came and went, and then I believe he came again. And this guy, well, he wasn't really a cast member on the show, but he seems to be on a lot. But anyway, tonight on the Captain Caribou Show, we're doing something completely new. You might notice a change, and then again, you might not. But as we see it here, it's a totally new show. So sit back and see if you notice the changes ahead. And those changes will be starting right after this commercial message. Oh, and stay tuned after the show, because I, Todd Magnuson, have a very special announcement to make. So go ahead, watch this important message, and afterwards we'll start the new show.
I used to have America Online, and that was, you know, okay for what it was, but I really liked to download a lot of big files, and the speed just wasn't doing it for me. When I would download files, it would take forever. Like I was downloading this movie one time, and it said it was going to take like 4 hours, and I really didn't have 4 hours. So now that I have cable internet, the files just download faster than I can, you know, possibly imagine. I'm Scott Pearson, convicted sex offender, and I've got a cable modem.
Start the meeting.
What's your name, Pete?
Pete. Okay. Call this meeting to order.
Ouch. Order. Just wait a minute. I got something.
Hey, just wait a minute.
What?
I got this. I think everyone probably got this note, this letter.
Hey, how come yours smells like perfume?
Shh. See? Meeting, all this stuff. But why do we have to sneak here? Why couldn't we just meet at headquarters like we normally do?
Well, I'll tell you about it. The reason we're meeting here at this park is because we can't meet at headquarters. This is a secret meeting, and we need to meet at a secluded location because the walls have ears, you know, and this is secret. That's why.
Hey, if this is a secret meeting, then why are we showing it on TV?
This isn't TV, it's just Fox. But anyway, we got two very important things to meet about here. Not life-threatening. Pretty big. Anyway, first thing is, I don't know how to tell you guys this, but Ernie quit the show.
For good? You mean he's dead?
I don't know. Yeah, probably. So, since I assume that he's dead, I think we should take this moment to have like a moment of silence in honor of Ernie.
Put your cap on.
Outside of swearing and stuttering, what else did he do? And that got old after about 2 years.
Ah, finally, that Ernie's dead. Makes my day. Wait, did he finish my intern papers?
Yeah, I'm glad that Ernie's gone. I think it was a Democrat. You don't need none of that around here. But, all them Democrats, they lost that election. You know, and they say it's because they didn't generate their base. I wonder if I found some hot Democrat chick if I walked up to her and say, "Hey, baby, I'll generate your base." I wonder if that'd work out for me.
First we lost Bob Upchuck, and now Peter Chang. The mother of those brothers must be really sad.
Hey, now that Ernie's gone, I can probably take this damn fartifier out of my ass.
So Ernie's dead? Didn't we already do this show?
Okay, that's enough reflecting thought now. Anyway, so that's one order of business. The second order of business is this. We need to change the name of the show.
Well, why do we have to do that?
Because I found out Captain Caribou's not really a captain!
Okay, I've got to admit it. I'm not a captain. I wasn't in the military. Hell, I don't even own a boat.
But wait. What are we going to call the show now?
Well, let's all come up with a good name for the show.
I know. Let's call it Wheel of Fortune.
No, you idiot. That's already taken. I got a better name. How about we call it The Scott Pearson Show?
No.
That's a terrible idea. And since we're all whores to consumer goods, let's name it the Mr. T Experience Show.
The Mr. T Experience? I pity the fool that calls it the Mr. T Experience.
You got a better idea?
Let's call it the Caribou Captain Show.
No. Those aren't going to work. Those are all really good ideas, but I got a good idea. How about we call it that damn son of a Ernie ain't on the show?
Yeah, that's pretty good and all, but I don't think the TV Guide channel would print it. But hey, I got an idea. You know all the kids out there, they got that hip slang?
Yeah.
I heard that all the kids call the show now the Caribou Show. Just the Caribou Show. That's like hip and cool.
Really?
Yeah.
That sounds like a pretty good name to me. As long as my name's still in it, what the hell? Let's go with that name.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so from now on, it's the Caribou Show.
Caribou Show.
All right.
Caribou Show it is.
Well, that's all well and good, but now that Ernie's not in the show and we got a new name, we got to come up with like a new show opening theme song or something.
Oh, that's true.
We can do that.
Well, let's all think about how we think the new opening should be. Chip. gotta think of a new intro for the show, huh? And we all gotta rub our chins and think of what we think the new intro is gonna be like, huh?
Thank you.
think Dan's is probably the best, don't you guys?
I think Dan's pretty good.
All right, we're going to go with Dan's then. So.
All right.
All right. Well, ready to start the show. Okay, well, tonight's show ought to be really great.
Ought to be really good.
Yeah, you really good.
Yeah.
Whenever there's a crime, who's always there to fight it? Whenever there's a wrong, who's always there to right it? When someone breaks the law, who do people holler for? It's the Batman. It's the Batman. When someone tries to plot, I'll hold up for a killing.
Hi, I'm Todd Magnuson, and I play Mr. Helper on the new Caribou Show. You may or may not have noticed that there aren't that many political ads on TV anymore. And if you're like me, you really miss them. That's why I'm pleased to announce that me, Todd Magnuson, will be running for United States Senator from South Dakota in the 2004 Senate elections. And beginning soon, you will see some hard-hitting political advertising by me, Todd Magnuson, to show what a good candidate I would be and what a crappy candidate that Tom DeShelley would be, or however you pronounce it. You may be wondering why me, Todd Magnuson, a successful entertainer, would want to run for the United States Senate. Well, I can sum up my reasons in three words. Gopher from Love Boat. Last four words. Anyway, that's the reason he ran for Congress and he won, and he was an entertainer, sort of. And, well, if he can do it, so can I. But that's not the main reason I'm running for the United States Senate. The main reason can be summed up in these three important reasons. Number one, senators make a lot of money. I like money, and I like to buy a lot of things. And those senators, they just roll in the money, so that's a good thing for me. And senators, they don't have to take a civil service exam or a drug test or anything. So that's the most important thing, money. Number two, remember that Gary Hart, that senator from Colorado? He had that affair with that Donna Rice. Man, she was hot. Whew. And this, I'm not against having some of that senator booty. So heck, I want to be senator and I want to get all the chicks. So dang it, that's a good enough reason right there. And finally, number three, what I've seen on that C-SPAN, which isn't that much, because, boy, is that boring. Anyway, all I can tell is all senators do is vote for stuff. Heck, I can do that. I've voted for stuff for years. So I got a lot of experience. So vote for me November 3rd or 4th or whatever voting day is way in 2004. And if you're living on an Indian reservation, vote for me several times. I think that my voting experience and my brutal honesty will be a refreshing change in Senator Land, wherever Senator Land is. I think it's someplace out east. But let me tell you, vote for me and not that Tom DeShelley, or whatever his name is. Let me tell you, I met that Tom once, and he smelled like he took a bath in Old Spice. Woo! And I also think his hair is not real. I think it's a fake. And look at this. That's real. Real, I'm real. So vote for me coming up in that 2004 election. And thanks a lot for your support. And stay tuned, because pretty soon you'll be seeing me all over the TV like you did that Johnson and Thune guys. And boy, that'll be something good. So thanks a lot. Thanks for your vote, which I'm sure you'll give me. And that's about it. So that's it. What?